It's our senses that connect us to materials and make us human. In the remote landscapes of northern Sweden, one man is crossing the boundaries between human and machine. He's been called Europe's first cyborg. In 2013, 10 years after his cancerous right arm was amputated, Magnus Niska agreed to test a revolutionary artificial hand that would be controlled by his own mind.
This arm is really amazing. I use it to everything.
With advanced materials that fuse with human tissue, the science fiction of the bionic man is becoming science fact. Magnus lives with his wife and young family in the small Swedish town of Haparanda. After struggling with a conventional prosthesis, he agreed to test one that would be bolted directly into his bone and connected to his nervous system. It transformed his life. With his prosthetic hand, Magnus controls movements with signals from his brain. If he wants to pick up a jigsaw piece, the hand responds.
With this arm, I can work with almost everything. It's not feeling like a machine. It's more like my own arm. In the family life, I don't feel handicapped.
So how does this prosthetic arm work? Scientists are now learning how to interpret the signals from the brain. Electrodes implanted in Magnus's arm transmit signals from his brain to the hand, from man to machine. Miles away in Gothenburg, Max Ortiz Catalan is the brains behind the technology.
You have the cuff electrode that is for the nerve, and this one also has a lot of different platinum iridium contacts inside that are arranged in a special way so you get a high signal to noise ratio.
The implanted electrodes, unlike usual skin electrodes, live permanently within the human body and will connect directly to Magnus's nerve tissue.
You will open it and go around the nerve and place the nerve inside there, and then you will just let it coil around it. The reliability of these electrodes, or the whole system actually, is very important because these are not toys. People use these devices to assist them on their activities of their daily living. And that's why we're doing this, because we want the control to be more intuitive.
But something is still missing, a sense of touch. What if the signals could go both ways and the brain could interpret what the artificial hand touches? Researcher Laura Dana Zollo believes it's possible.
La nostra grande sfida è quella di poter arrivare ad impiantare una mano protesica ad un amputato e sentire l'amputato che dice io sento che è una mia mano.
12 years ago, Dennis Sorensen lost his left hand in a firework accident. In 2013, he volunteered to take part in the pioneering Life Hand 2 experiment.
For me, it was kind of a duty when I thought this is so exciting and I really would like to be a part of this huge project.
Dennis traveled from his home in Denmark to Rome.
Hello, Professor. Thank you.
Where he underwent a grueling 7-hour operation. 4 electrodes were implanted into his nerves, which connected to this hand via a computer interface. What happened next was remarkable.
Soft. Hot.
Amazingly, Dennis was feeling sensations from an artificial hand.
They put this round object in the life hand, and I squeezed around it, and I could immediately tell that it was around. After 10 years where you haven't had any kind of sensation of a form, then suddenly you're able to actually feel again in your lost hand. That was really incredible and something I will never forget in my life. It was really a special moment.
The Life Hand 2 experiment restored sensation that Dennis thought he'd lost forever. But unfortunately for him, the experiment was authorized only for 30 days. New materials, however amazing, need to be safe.
Che gli elettrodi sono stati testati e quindi la loro efficacia, la loro sicurezza è stata dimostrata per quel periodo. Quindi l'estensione a un periodo più lungo richiede naturalmente test di verifica di sicurezza che più approfonditi.
The electrodes had to be removed and his sense of touch in that arm was lost once more.
The fact that it was taken away again, I knew from the start, and yeah, it was just incredible, and I was very proud and also humbled to be the one who was selected for the project.
Loredana and her team continue their painstaking work. But merging man and machine brings with it new responsibilities. Is society ready to rethink what it is to be human?